Today we're in an attic and I want to show you how to hook up a gas furnace. You can tell that the furnace is gas, usually when it's got some pipes going to the ceiling for the exhaust. The pipe doesn't always look like this. Sometimes just a couple white pipes that go up. I don't really understand it too much, but I know that it needs an exhaust, no matter what they got. I've seen steel pipes. And it's a good indicator if you're in a new neighborhood and you don't know if the neighborhood is gas or electric. You can always, like, if the HVAC beats you here and it's before the gas guys, you can look up here and see if the pipes are running straight up to the ceiling. Then you know it has an exhaust, so it's going to be gas, and that'll help you wiring the rest of the house, like if you're beating the gas guys here. But fortunately for us, the gas is done and HVAC is done, so I'm going to show you how to hook up the gas furnace all the way. I've already ran my 12-2 from the panel up here and threw up some extra because I'm going to need a little bit, because I'm not putting a big 60 amp disconnect for this. This one has a cheaper way of doing it instead of the big wire. If this was an electric one, then we would have to do one of the pull tab disconnects. But this one doesn't need much power because all we're doing is we're giving power for the igniter light for the gas. So 12-2, I'm just used to running 12-2 to these gas furnaces, which is just a regular 20 amp breaker in the panel. But like I said, this thing doesn't need much power at all. It's all gas pretty much. But anyways, I ran this wire and I put a staple down there, and this is going to be my junction for my disconnect. So I'm just going to pick an area that's easy for me to work in above and behind it. Alright, just going to measure some of this off. And this is my power coming in from my panel. Okay. And this is gonna be my switch load. It's still just one hot, a neutral, and a ground. So I'm gonna run it. See, I can see where the knockout is on this unit. So I'm just going to try to keep my wire near there. So I'm going to go underneath this thing and try to make it look neat. Put this in. Put a couple staples in it. Look nice. One within 12 inches of the box. Then another staple just to keep these wires tight. Yeah, I gotta add another staple over here. So now that we got our switch leg hanging over here, we'll just leave that alone for a minute. And I'm gonna go ahead and cut in the switch. And this is just a regular single pole switch. My ground.
Okay.
Yeah, these 12 too, they're kind of hard to get on these tiny screws. Then I like to go ahead and write something on here. Say H for air handler. All right. Oops. Okay. So now we still have our switch leg. Just measure a little bit off. I got a little too much. And then we're gonna remove this cover from the unit. All right, and this is a half inch knockout. So you gotta use some kind of half inch grommet. I'm just using the plastic one. Sometimes people use those metal ones. Don't really matter. Okay, now I'm gonna feed this in, down and behind everything. Okay. All right, I don't have this little hex head bit for this little screw. There's a little junction box for the electrical. So I'm just gonna twist this off of my Klein's. Any day now. Okay. All right, so I got three wires in here. Gonna take a little bit off. Take a little bit more off of this. And even though this is a complicated piece of equipment, it's still just hot, neutral, and ground. Make sure it's in there tight. You can pull on it a little bit. Just make sure it's not gonna slip out. Oh, what the fuck? I'm an idiot sometimes. Okay. Fold these things up in here tight. And then make sure that this wire isn't touching anything. Okay, let's put our cover back on. What do I do with this screw? Right here. All right, and then let's put our cover back on.
this strap right here, didn't I?
And I saw the little tab was broken off on this bottom. Well, that's good. And that's how you hook up a gas furnace.